did this to you? What did he look like, Sally? We need to know.
469 from 92, are you receiving?
Go ahead, Sarge.
Sit rep, please, Polly.
Blood pressure's
dropping. I'm trying to get a description now, Sarge. Come on, Sally, who slashed you?
Occupational hazard, eh, Gary?
What is?
Tom's being snatched. It's a miracle it don't happen three times a week.
Eddie, just drive, will you?
Yeah, can you stand by, Matt?
Gary.
Right, who dialed 999?
No.
Dear Oscar from 92. Yeah, go ahead, Matt.
Yeah, read the emergency call concerning Sally Ferris. The caller didn't leave his name. We're tracing it now.
Matthew.
92 from Sierra Oscar 1. The DI's been informed about your knifing incident.
Received, sir.
Have you a description of the attacker yet?
Right, if you two can start a door to door, see if any of the residents saw anything.
Yes, sir. Yeah, what's the victim look like, Sarge?
Oh, yeah, sorry, Eddie. IC3, 17, 18, 5 foot four-ish, long dark hair.
Sometimes.
Yeah, she was wearing a beige top, black miniskirt, black sandals. All of Oprah's know her.
We have a looker, is she?
She isn't at the moment, no.
Sally's got a drug habit.
Yeah, flashes of Tom. I get it, local pest. Let one of her punters stuck her up for a bit for free, yeah?
You never look less of a theory, Peter. As far as I'm concerned, Sally is a teenage girl who's just had her face slashed. And no matter what she does for a living, she's entitled to the same protection as everyone else.
She's been a realist, Sarge.
Well, don't. It's wasting time. And we're all well aware of your attitude towards women.
Not a good idea upsetting your sergeant, Eddie.
Story of my life.
92 from 469, receiving.
Go ahead, Polly.
Yeah, I can't get to Sally at the moment, Sarge. They're treating her. She's got some cuts to the side of her face.
And a bad wound on her right forearm. Just missed an artery.
Yeah, all right, Polly, stay with her. Get back to me as soon as you can.
Carrie? Your mate Sally's just been stabbed. Let her rush her to St. Hugh's Hospital.
The bastard cut her.
Who has?
I don't know his name. There's no one we knew, just some nutter trying to get cash off us.
Did you pay him?
Of course not. I can cough up to any nutter that asks.
But did he threaten you?
No. He did, Sal. Showed her a great big cleaver and told her to pay up or else.
Why didn't you report this?
If we reported every threat we got, we'd be down the neck 10 times a day.
Okay, what did he look like? Black, white?
White. Big, lardy bastard. Covered in tattoos on his neck.
Tattoos?
Yeah. Looks like he pumps iron all day.
All right, Carrie. I might have to talk to you again about this.
No way. I don't make statements. I'd rather be murdered. I've got to get some facts.
Pierre Oscar from 92, you're receiving.
Go ahead, man.
Yeah, Matt, can you do me a DIU check on Alvin Morton?
Received, Bob. The knife man, he's still banged up at Longmarsh, isn't he?
Yeah, but I've just had a description that fits him to a T.
Why did when you lot appear, Long?
Livia, do you, sir?
What have you doing this to someone else's steps?
Yeah. I don't suppose you saw a teenage girl, stark, 5'4"-ish.
The one they took off in the ambulance.
That's the one. You see the attack?
No. Well, I saw the bloke she was with. Those young sluts go for little driveabouts, you know.
Yeah, what's this bloke look like?
35-ish, white, small black beard.
You must have seen his car then.
Blue Mercedes.
You get the wretch?
No, car stop for these girls all the time. I only noticed because he had one of those silly EU stickers on the back. What's wrong with a good old GB sign?
What indeed, eh, sir? We may need a fuller statement from you.
I haven't got time to go diddling off down the police station.
Problem. I'll do you here.
Sarge, that emergency call came from 22 Clackett Road, a dental surgery. Phones in the name of Dr. B. Farmer.
Received you, Miller.
92 from Sierra Oscar. Read your name check. Alvin Morton was let out on parole from Longmarsh 10 days ago.
Cheers, Matt.
Can't believe he's out again already.
Yeah, Carrie Bennett said someone resembling Morton threatened Sally with a knife.
And we're slashing the 17-year-old girl's about par for Alvin.
Sarge, that dentist is only a few streets away. Do you want us to check him out?
No, Eddie can drive me over there. If you two could dig out Morton's parole address, get it off probation, I better let Polly know that Morton's on the prowl.
Oh, and listen, if you see Morton lumbering around, don't tackle him alone.
You bet. He's probably got a machete stuck in his top pocket.
Who attacked you, Sally? Was it the man who threatened you with a knife?
You mean talking to Carrie?
Did he come to collect? Is that what this is all about? Look, if it was him who attacked you, you've got nothing to be afraid of.
How'd you make that, eh?
Well, his name's Alvin Morton. He's out on parole. One statement from you and he'll be straight back inside. Look, do you want him to use his knife on you again?
No, I don't. All right.
The 2Ks? What are you doing here?
Oh, no. It's PC Polly Parrott.
It's safety time. Like you don't take no drugs when you're crossing a road.
Sorry, miss, but we're not at school anymore.
I know you're not at school, Keith. You were never at school when you were supposed to be, nor you, Kenny. And I can guess what you've been up to since.
She'll be having us turn out our pockets next.
Well, now you mention it.
Oh, she's serious. Well, sorry, miss. No ease today.
What are you two doing here?
Oh, see our little friend, didn't we?
Friend?
Give you this. I'm saving it for someone special.
The bloke will put you in here. I'm gonna lay it on his grave.
Is that all you brought?
Right, come on, you two. Can you wait outside? Me and Sally are in the middle of talking.
No, we're not. Get out!
I think the patient's asking you to leave.
Look, Sally, you're making a mistake. These two won't help you.
I don't want Noel.
Okay, that's how you want it?
Yeah, it is. Bye.
Bye.
I found someone who saw Ferris getting into a car.
Sally and her mate Carrie get in and out of cars around here about 20 times a day. Surprising if someone didn't see him doing it. Anyone mention a big, heavily tattooed IC1 male?
No, why? Something turned up.
They got a possible Alvin Morton.
But I still reckon it was one of her punters.
That come from anything definite, Eddie?
Well, not really, but...
Well, tell me when it does.
What's up?
We're there. 22 Clackett Road, like you asked.
Sierra Oscar from 988, vehicle check, please. November 84, Romeo Charlie Yankee.
Received. Stand by.
At 1:45.
That's when someone used your phone to dial 999.
Well, it wasn't me. I was at lunch.
Oh, what about Dr. Falmer?
No, he would have told me.
Would you mind if we asked him?
Look, I'll see what I can do.
Thank you kindly.
I think I might have stumbled on something, Sarge.
Mm.
Yeah, remember I told you about someone seeing Sally getting into a car?
Yeah. Not now, Eddie.
You're aware you're interrupting my work?
Dr. Falmer, I appreciate that, sir, but we need to trace the person who called the emergency services from this building.
Well, I did. I was driving home from lunch and I saw some woman who looked in trouble, so as soon as I got back here, I phoned.
Well, why didn't you give your name when you called the ambulance?
I don't see why I should get involved.
The woman was attacked. Did you see that?
No. You didn't stop?
No.
You didn't recognise the girl who'd been assaulted?
No, of course not. I've never seen her before.
Is that your blue Mercedes parked up outside?
Yes. What's that got to do with it?
Well, what you say, sir, about not stopping and not knowing the girl doesn't quite square with one of our other witnesses' statements.
Perhaps we'd better discuss this somewhere else. Fander, I've got a few minutes while Mr. Slingsby's anaesthetic takes. Let him know I won't be long. I'd prefer if we went to your car, sir.
If you think so.
Can't imagine why Dr. Farmer never mentioned this 999 call to me.
Can't you? I can.
Got a witness who saw Ferris get out of this car. Described the driver too. Look like you.
Look, I can explain.
Are you her client? Did you attack Sally Ferris?
No.
Right, you examine your car, please.
Why?
Just open the car, please.
What are you? What's he looking for?
Blood. The attacker would have been covered in it.
I had nothing to do with it.
Those are trousers you were wearing.
Yes.
Eddie.
Look, what are you? There's no blood on me. Well, I didn't do it.
Got to check Dr. Farmer, you know. You were the last person to see me with the victim before she was stabbed.
All right, okay, I saw it.
Judge.
Right, I was dropping her off, and this madman suddenly comes charging towards us. I thought he was going to attack me, so I drove off. I was only just in time. When I looked in the mirror, I could see her being attacked.
Did you see the knife?
So. Blood spurting from her face.
What did this man look like?
Oh, big. Heavy build. Maybe 40-odd. Yeah, blue denim jacket and jeans.
Anything else?
Yes, I think he had tattoos.
What do you think?
He had tattoos on his face, on his hands.
Well, it must have been pretty close for you to see all that.
Well, the maniac nearly caught me. I'm innocent. Look. I'll do whatever you say. You want me to make a statement? Fine, I'll do it.
Yeah, we will. We want to show you photographs, see if you really can identify this man.
Right, I'll come right away. I'll tell my receptionist I'm feeling sick or something. I am feeling sick.
That's right, Dr. Farmer. You can come along and see us later if it's necessary.
Will you let me go?
You ought to get back to your patient before the anaesthetic wears off.
Right. Right, thanks.
Well, that's it. We just let him go.
Well, he's a witness, not a suspect. That's self-evident. How would he be able to describe Morton if he hadn't seen him?
You say so.
The thing I want to know now, Eddie, is why didn't you acquaint me with your information about Sally and Falmer before I started questioning them?
I tried to, Sarge, but he didn't seem interested.
Okay, fair enough. But watch it. When you work with me, you do things my way.
Alvin Morton, GBH with intent, 8 years in Longmarsh now, out on parole.
And up to his old tricks.
Bob and Eddie have dug up this dentist, a Dr. Falmer. He saw the assault taking place.
Well, he'll identify Morton. What's the problem?
Falmer was Sally Ferris's client.
Well, he said he'll give a statement.
Oh, yeah. How did you manage that?
Well, I pointed out to Dr. Falmer that he was the last person to be seen with the victim. He's anxious not to be a suspect, so he's bending over backwards to be helpful.
Well, he'll stop doing that as soon as he realises he's in the clear, won't he? You also need to believe that this dentist is going to stand up in court in a few months' time, point the finger at Morton as the person who stabbed a 17-year-old prostitute when she'd just serviced him. Do me a favour.
Did Sally say who attacked her?
Well, not in so many words.
Will she make a statement?
Well,
if she doesn't, we'll have to drop it. We've got no complaint.
Chris, Morton's a problem that won't go away.
If he can't lean on the local pushers and the prostitutes, he's going to start on the local shopkeepers.
Well, Bob, you tell me when he does, and I'll nick him.
Is that Alvin? Not a pretty sight. Sarge, Sally was just about to spill the beans when guess who walked in? The two Ks. Keith Janner and Kenny Durant. Remember them?
Well, like the plague years. What were they doing there?
Well, they said they were her friends, but she clammed up as soon as she saw them. But I've been thinking, Keith and Kenny have been doing small-scale drug pushing since they left school. And what if they've expanded?
Meaning?
Well, girls like Sally go on the game to pay for their drug habit. So what if Keith and Kenny are not only selling the girls drugs, but they run them as well?
Double their profit.
Yeah, and their perks.
Have Keith and Kenny got the clout for pimping? As I remember, they're not exactly heavyweight.
No, but they're plenty nasty enough in their own way.
If Jana and Durant have a vested interest, that explains the hospital visit. They want to know who damaged their goods.
Carrie was rabbiting away on her mobile. She must have been telling the Kays where Sally was.
And Kenny made it more than clear that he wanted to sort things out.
Well, I don't see how. Well, they wouldn't be any wiser of where Morton was.
More's the pity.
What's that?
That sounds like if Polly had pointed those two boys in the right direction, they'd have done the job for us.
What do you mean by that?
Well, if, like the DI says, we're going to drop it, it could be as good a way as any of getting Morton off the scene.
Don't believe I'm hearing this. Are you suggesting we set up some kind of mindless bloodbath?
It's a joke, Sarge.
At Sun Hill, we try not to encourage turf wars between villains, Eddie. We prefer more conventional ways of keeping the crime figures down.
Yeah, you know, like nicking people.
Look, why don't you two take refs, hmm?
Sir.
Sir.
Did you have to bite his head off, Bob? He said he was only joking.
Well, I can't accept it, sir, even in jest.
Well, ease off him a bit. We all know Eddie's had a few problems recently, but we mustn't let that cloud our judgment of him.
Well, I'm sorry, sir, but Eddie Santini was just advocating some kind of half-baked slag-on-slag policy. Now, if he believes the answer is setting off one villain against the other, somewhere down the line, all of us are going to be in a lot of trouble.
Perhaps we can get back to the matter in hand, which is getting shot of Alvin Morton.
See, I don't see Cryer's squeaky clean approach getting us anywhere with Morton. If that bit of brass that got stabbed is too much of a whim to testify. You've got to be realistic. She can't be bothered, so why should we?
There are nutters out there going around stabbing people, Eddie, and you expect us to do nothing?
No, I say we put them all in a ring together and throw in as many guns and knives as they want.
Yeah, I'll throw them in any tank gun.
And I'll sell tickets.
I bumped into Alvin Morton's ex-girlfriend, you haven't
I? Is that so, Reg?
Nadia Collins. Very likeable lady, as it goes.
I remember Nadia. Used to be on the game, didn't she?
Yeah, that's how I met her.
That must have been nice for Rick.
No. Strictly in the line of duty.
What's funny?
Nah, Sarge, I'm just saying I know Alvin Morton's ex-girlfriend, Nadia Collins. Yeah, she works at the Camberton Hotel. Well, she practically runs the place, actually.
Is this important, Rich?
Well, I think it is, sir.
That doesn't mean much.
Sarge, the thing is, I don't think she knows that Morton's back out on the rampage again. Well, I think someone ought to tell her.
Good point, Reg. Anyway, you, Gary, Sam, George, we've got Morton's address off probation, so let's pay him a visit. With any luck, he'll feel that his parole's at risk. Get rattled, drop himself in it.
I'm not sure I like the sound of that, Sarge. I mean, Morton's hardly the brain of Britain, is he, eh? What happens if he does panic, goes ape?
That's why we've got you in the team, George. You can go in first.
Yeah, you look on the bright side, George. Morton gives you the chop, we'll nick him. Yeah.
That's all right, then.
And Polly, if you can do what Reg suggests, pop into the Cam Burton, tip Nadia off about Morton.
Sarge.
Let's take Eddie along with you, all right? Right, come on.
Oh, look, lads, just an idea. Before anyone upsets Morton, can we make sure he hasn't got any cutlery on?
Do you know what, Eddie? I think it's about time you started building bridges with Sergeant Cryer.
Yeah, I'm not fussed.
He's not in. He's never in. You know what? That suits me.
I'd like to see for ourselves if you don't mind, Mr. Newley.
Mr. Morton, got some friends of yours out here.
Have a key, Mr. Newley? Make sure.
Oh, what a surprise. Mr. Morton isn't in.
Okay. We're just round the corner from where Sally got stabbed. I'm gonna have a crack at Carrie Bennett, see if she's holding anything back. See you back at base.
Nadia's room's number 6. She's in the staff annex.
Yeah, what do you reckon they'd say if they knew what her previous job was?
Well, actually, Eddie, I was thinking maybe it'd be better if I dealt with Nadia on my own.
Oh, why is that then?
Well, let's just say you're not quite on the right wavelength for what I've come to say to her.
Yeah, all right, Paul, yeah, no problem, so I'll wait here.
All right, won't be long.
Ooh, that looks nice. Suppose a cappuccino's out of the question. Well, that's if you don't mind moving for it.
I'm on my break.
Sorry I asked. Ooh,
Hotel's got its very own personalised matches. It's very swish. The Camberton. The Camberton. Clearly the place to be.
What are you doing here?
I'm looking for Nadia Collins.
Why?
What's she doing here?
Says she's come to see you.
Me? No. Why?
Maybe because you sent for her.
988 from
465,
receiving. Room number 6, Eddie.
I'm locating Mr. Morton. Quick as you can.
Do anything about me! Not Mr. Morton!
Eddie!
469 from 92, you're receiving.
Yes, all right, Sarge, everything's under control.
Holly?
9-2, we can deal.
So if you need backup, we can be there in seconds.
Sarge, did you get that?
Yeah, I heard.
Yes, it'd be nice to us, or the heavy mob would be round to bounce you straight back into Longmarsh, Nick. You understand? Understand?
Yeah.
Good.
Right, we want to talk to you two separately. Nadia, would you mind waiting outside for a moment? Right. Now, where were you at 20-2 this afternoon?
Yeah. She'll tell you that.
Oh, we'll ask her. And what were you wearing before you took a shower?
Why?
Never mind why, just answer the lady's question.
Then.
Oh, you normally wash your clothes and take a shower in the middle of the day.
You tell me what's normal. I've just done 8 years, Nick.
And you'll be right back inside if you don't watch it. Now, just answer the question.
Nad had a load for the hotel wash. I just threw my gear in with it, that's all.
Covered in blood, was it?
I don't know what you're on about.
No. A couple of hours ago, a man answering your description was seen attacking a young woman.
Well, it wasn't me. I was here.
And he was wearing blue denims like those.
And 10 million others.
Got any knives, Alvin?
No. Look for yourself.
Where is it then, huh?
The knife you slashed Sally Ferris with.
Who?
You know who. The 17-year-old bit of brass you felt man enough to lean on.
Not me.
Wait here. And Alvin, if you want to do us a real big favour, you'll hop out that window and do a runner. That way your parole will be completely blurred. Yeah, think about it.
What did they have to go and let him out for? I was doing all right on my own. Nadia, did Alvin do that to you? Look, Nadia, if he's being violent towards you, it's in your best interest to let us know.
Oh, sure. That'd do me a fat lot of good.
Look, has Alvin been with you all day?
Is that what he says?
Never mind what he says. What do you say?
Who's Alvin going to blame if his alibi don't work out? Me. And where are you two going to be then?
Well, we nick him, you've got nothing to worry about, have you?
No. And what about when he sends one of his ex-cellmates round to bother me? I like this job. It means a lot to me. If you want to nick him, go ahead. Just leave me out of it.
Stays here, does he, Alvin?
No crime if he does, is it?
Your boss away. He's got a man of Alvin's pedigree living here. Don't suppose he knows about your previous work experience either. Or did you include streetwalking in your CV? Yeah. Feeling any more helpful?
So that's the way it goes, is it? Okay. Get your little book out. Alvin!
What?
Listen to this. I, Nadia Collins, am stating that Alvin Morton was with me all day. Got what you wanted.
Nice one, Nan.
Come in, Eddie.
Go on. Shove off.
You want to watch it, Alvin? The new boy's on the block now and they'll kipper an old has-been like you for breakfast.
So now I'm supposed to be frightened of two twerp kids, am I?
Well, how do you know I'm talking about? Next time I see you, I'll bring my shovel.
You wish. Nice.
last one.
What's going on, Eddie? I was getting on fine till you butted in. I mean, what were you playing at?
Just warn him off.
You wasn't warning him off, you were winding him up. 9-2 from 469 receiving.
Yeah, go ahead, Polly.
Yeah, Nadia says that Morton was with her at the time of the assault.
Alex, room 6.
I know. Do you want the room number of where he's holding out?
No, not over the air. Save it for when you see me later.
Received.
That wasn't too painful, was it?
No, thanks to you, it wasn't. You caught that knife man yet?
No, not yet. Do we know about your link with Jana and Durant?
Yeah. Just friends.
It's a cosy little world you live in, isn't it, Carrie? These men that pay you to go in their car, they're just friends. So are the pimps that come round and take your money off you. And I suppose when this bloke turns up with his machete, he's just going to be another friend to you, is he?
Probably.
And who's going to get hurt, Carrie? Eh? Your two novice pimps? The very unpredictable knife man? Or the mug in the middle? You?
He won't.
No. The two Ks aren't going to be able to help you. They don't know where to find Morton. But he knows where you are.
He won't touch me. I told him I'd pay. I told Sam to say the same. Buy us a bit of time till we get it sorted.
Yeah, who's going to get it sorted? The two Ks or me?
I told you I'm not making any statements. I wouldn't last a week.
But you've promised Morton to pay the money, have you?
Yes.
Arrange a time and a place?
Yes.
Right, well then there is another way.
Now, there's something specially nasty about Morton. I mean, when he looks at you, it's like he's only looking for a place to stick his knife in. Like he can already see your blood pouring out.
You can't push your foot around with knife men. You heard D.I. Deakin, they're going to drop it. That scum of the earth is going to get away with it. What about these two Ks? Yeah, they heavy?
No, they're kids, really. I mean, smart enough. Into everything and getting away with it, mostly.
Where they operate from?
Dizzy's.
Where's that?
It's a snooker club on Braganza Road.
All right.
What are we doing?
Well, let's pay him a visit.
Why?
Well, we've got a few minutes. Let's take a leaf out of Sergeant Cry's book and warn him off.
All right, then. Make sure you do a better job than you did with Alvin Morton, though.
Morton went for Ferris's face to make an example of her, so that the next time he asked for money, he'd get it.
What about the girl's pimps?
Well, obviously he doesn't rate them. He spent so long inside doing 500 press-ups a day, he thinks he's invincible. But as soon as he found out that the girl's pimps were teenagers, he couldn't resist.
The problem is, none of the three females involved, Ferris, Bennett or Nadia Collins, seem keen to make a statement.
Well, if they don't, that's that.
But there's more than one way to skin a cat.
You got a plan B?
Yeah, a fresh offence. You're right, he is expecting to get paid. He's arranged to meet Carrie in the Eskel Arms. And she told me he's collecting cash of her at 8 tonight.
Was she willing to play ball?
Yeah. Well, she won't stand up in court for us, but she's agreed to stand at the bar all wired up. So if we can't get him for his previous knife work, we can nick him for demanding money with menaces.
Blackmail? That'd be enough to send him back.
You haven't got much time to set it up, and it's yours if you want it.
I want it. Joint uniform CID?
Fine with me.
Bob's babe, yeah?
Okay with you, Bob?
Yeah, it's more than okay with me, sir.
Right, we're on. Let's get it organised.
Hi, Kay. Polly Barrett's brought the budget.
These are the two Ks, Keith and Kenny. Eddie Santini.
Oh. Better watch your step, Kay. Mr. Santini might have a connection.
Yeah, the ice cream side of the family.
Wanna go?
Gotta put your weekly wedge on the table first.
It's not worth playing for, Kay. So what do you want? Help with your inquiries?
No, we don't need help from little yobblets like you. No, we're here more in an advisory capacity. How'd you go to St. Hughes? You check out those nice clean hospital beds.
Is he budging on a bet?
Because I reckon it could be time to book yourselves into one.
Whoa. This case is giving us a bit of heavy duty ice cream, Kay.
The man you're interested in.
Oh, Morton. That's the name you said, wasn't it?
Where's he hang out, this Alvin character?
There's no way I'm going to say that.
Never you mind where he is.
Dead keen on meeting you two, though. Called you a couple of, twerp kids. Oh, I gave him that impression.
Come on, Eddie. Time to leave.
Right. Abracadabra. Kids' tricks. Have a nice day, boys.
Crude, but effective.
Really? I don't think you understand. I've got sensitive skin.
It's a bit of a drawback in your profession, isn't it, Carrie? Well, I think that'll do. You ready?
Yeah. Let's hope this Morton character keeps his post himself. We'd want him stumbling in this little lot.
It's not your body he's interested in. It's the cash. And there you go. 520s. And keep them separate from your own. We want to find them on him when we nick him. Yeah. All right?
Yeah.
Let's go.
What, no rehearsal?
We do it in the van.
Right.
Can you go ahead, Liz?
Sarge. What's going on, Sarge?
All done and dusted. Morton's collecting cash off Carrie and got a team standing by to nick him.
Well, if Morton's not around, I could have another go at Nadia. See if I can get her to retract on the alibi.
That'd be good news. Yeah, try her at 8 while Morton's at the Ascot. Take Eddie with you.
Well, actually, Sarge, I'd rather go alone. And in plain clothes. Nadia really values her job at the hotel. The less uniforms they see, the better.
Yeah, okay, Polly. Do it.
Oh, Sarge, we've had a call on Jana and Durant.
What? Why keep those two pimps out of it?
Well, I couldn't agree more, Sarge. That's why we're going to warn them off. Right! What do you want me to do on this setup?
Nothing. Morton's going to recognise your face, isn't he? All right, you can team up with Gary, Luke and George. We're going to need a uniform presence at the Ascot in case things go wrong. It's not like I can imagine they will.
Had
a medieval
over
again.
A bit like the charge of
the
life
I've
got,
isn't
it?
Yeah, look what happened to them.
Ask Eddie.
Have fun.
Why aren't Gary and George in on the Askill?
Well, I mean Morton knows their face.
Well, he doesn't know mine.
No, Lou, nobody knows yours.
Come on.
Till he asks for the money.
What if he doesn't?
He will. That's what he's come for. And then ask him what he's going to do to you if you don't give him the money.
He's already told me what he's going to do. He's going to knife me.
Yeah, we know that, but we want to hear him say it on the tape. But don't worry, there's going to be half a dozen officers right next to you.
I could murder a wee body.
No, no alcohol. You want to keep your wits about you?
If you get frightened, Carrie, just scream. We'll do the rest.
Let's go for that.
So what now?
We wait.
Oh, don't you want to be where the action is?
I'm not fussed.
Well, I am. Do you think we're getting to the Askew?
Not unless something goes wrong.
Speak.
What do you want me to say?
Yeah, that'll do fine.
Okay. Over there.
You lot are going to owe me a few favours after this.
There was a downside to everything. Remember, saloon bar.
Yeah, I know. He's told me everything 10 times.
Harry.
What?
Make sure Morton speaks into the microphone.
All right. All right.
Cheers.
More chance of getting a drink in the Gobi Desert than in this place.
We manage, Reg.
Looks like Sam's getting lucky.
Not the only one, Tom. He's in with a chance, too.
He is.
Yes, my friend, can I, not long now.
Do you reckon Morton will have a knife on him?
More than likely.
Do you think he'll use it?
Won't get the chance. Of course, if he did, it wouldn't all be bad.
What do you mean?
If Morton sticks that tart, he'd get life, and know what?
What?
Sergeant Cryer fixed it up, he could get busted down to Constable.
Oh, come on, Ed, I can't imagine that.
I can.
Morton's running late. It's gone 8:10.
He'll come.
It's Polly I'm worried about. Well, I cleared out to visit Morton's girlfriend at 8. If he's not here, where is he?
What's going on, boys?
Sergeant Cryer's got us all watching that bird down there.
Which one?
The one down there that those two dopes are drooling over. That's what's going on.
Don't even think about it, matey.
It's your operation, Bob.
What's happened?
Shut it.
Sierra Oscar from
469, urgent medic.
Go ahead,
Polly. Converton Hotel, ambulance, please. Alvin Morton's been shot in the leg.
That's it.
Get down with the pen, Bob. I'll tell the others.
How'd this come about, Sarge?
So we're going to find out.
I didn't see anything.
I don't care what you saw. Get more towels.
Job's off.
More towels!
Right, I'm off.
You got that to work?
I'm gonna visit a friend.
Lucky fella.
It's a bird, actually, you clown.
Nadia.
Polly, you all right?
A bit shaky. I'll be okay in a couple of minutes, though.
Did you see it?
No, I was coming round the corner when I heard shots. It sounded like two bombs going off. And then Jenna and Durant came bursting past.
5 seconds earlier, you burst right in on it.
Yeah.
What's the score?
2 shots, 1 to each knee.
Did you find a gun?
Not on sight.
Carl. Well, that must be his. Has he used it?
Don't think he got the chance.
Did you see the shooting? No, she was in the bathroom, Liz.
I heard it, though.
That could be handy.
Polly, did you see Jenna or Durant with the gun?
No, it was too quick.
So, there was no chance of stopping?
Sorry, sir.
No, don't worry about that. Don't worry about that. We'll pick him up soon enough. Don, will you take care of that?
Go.
How did Jenna and Durant know he was here?
No idea, Gov.
Well, Alvin, who messed you up then? Is he with us or you doped him up?
I can hear you. He was big and black.
Black? Big?
About 9 foot tall.
Oh, good at basketball, no doubt, which is more than you're ever going to be.
We know who did it, Alvin.
Then why ask?
Because we need to hear it from you.
I don't help coppers.
Okay, we're ready.
Where are you taking him?
St. Hughes.
Liz, will you go with him? He might change his mind about talking when he realises how bad the damage is.
No one saw it. So if Morton doesn't make a complaint, we're back to square one.
My man, how the mighty have fallen, eh? Amazing, isn't it, what two twerp kids can do?
You scumbag, you set me up, I'm gonna get you for this.
Well, I don't think you'll be getting anybody anymore, Elvin. Do you?
Hi, Paul. You all right?
Well, no, not really.
A word outside.
You all right, Paul?
Yeah, I'm fine, you all right?
This is your doing, isn't it?
John about, Sarge?
Slag on slag. That's what you believe in, isn't it? That's what you've done in here.
Oh, these villains are always knocking each other off. You know that.
Just shut up and listen. Someone has told Jenna and Durant where to find Morton.
Not me.
No? You go and see Jenna and Durant and then, hey, presto, they're here.
Well, that's coincidence, Sarge.
Someone told them.
But I said nothing.
I don't believe you.
Well, all right, Sarge, don't. Don't. Ask Paul. She was with me all the time. Go on, ask her.
I will. You stay there.
Polly?
Sarge? Yeah.
Can you come out a minute, please?
Sarge.
Polly, when you and Eddie went round to see Jenna and Durant, did you tell them where Morton could be found?
Of course not.
Did he?
No. The two Ks asked Eddie where Morton was, but he refused point blank to tell him.
It's like I said, Sarge, it's just a coincidence.
Yeah. Okay, Polly, you better get Nadia down to the station. We need a statement off her. Thanks.
Sarge.
Suppose an apology's out of the question.
Too right. 20 minutes ago, Polly was that close to being blown away. If you had anything to do with it, I'm going to skin you alive.
You're not guilty, Sergeant. Now, with all due respect, perhaps you'd care to get off my back.
And what's the jacket, will you?
Right, what's he going to do?
Tricks? Delivery, June.
Two little nasty ones. This is Keith.
Janet and Kenny Durant, yeah. I remember the names.
Oh, my solicitor.
Yeah, I want him too.
Right, evidence of arrest?
How is he?
He'll live.
I know a few people would be sorry to hear that.
He might be away.
I'd say the same thing if he was.
Here he is. Looks peaceful, doesn't he?
Look even more peaceful if he pulled his tubes out. Reckon he'd die?
Dunno. Might be even better if we let him live, though. I've been asking about, and they reckon the wee soul will never walk again.
Yeah, right. Let him suffer. Two guys fixed him good.
Mr. Morton, he'll be quite harmless now. Perhaps we should have a little chat.
Look, me and my friend never even saw this Morton.
You were both seen running from his hotel room seconds after he was shot.
That don't mean nothing.
It will to a jury.
Look, we were going to see this Morton character. See when, like, all of a sudden these big bangs went off, didn't they? Well, we heard he fancied himself a bit of hard nut, so we split. We thought he was shooting at us, see?
So you saying that you and Kenny Durant never actually got into room 6?
Yeah. Not actually, no.
And you expect us to believe this nonsense, do you?
Look, have you got anyone who knows any different?
Then he said it won't be no use no more. Wouldn't reach Tempe a throw.
Because of her scars.
Jana said this.
No, Kenny.
Sergeant Cryer sent me to guard Mr. Morton.
Well, I don't think it'd be too much trouble, look. He's unlikely to do a runner. Shall we go and get that statement knocked off?
Go on, Sal. Let's stuff the bastards.
Right then.
We heard these big bangs.
And you ran away.
Yeah. Thought he was shooting at us, see?
That's exactly what your mate Keith said.
Well, it would, wouldn't it? Because that's what happened.
Word for word. Bit of a coincidence, isn't it?
No. We think alike.
Yes, I'm sure you do, Bob.
Since speaking to your friend, Mr. Janner, we've had a statement from the lady in the bathroom at the time of the shooting. And while you and your friend, Mr. Janner, may not have been seen with Alvin Morton, you were certainly heard.
Sound of voices. Think that might be a bit tenuous in court, Sergeant?
Well, try this. I heard one man say he's really mucked her up, hasn't he, Kay? I thought he must be speaking to a woman. But then I heard another man reply, too right, Kay. And then I thought, that doesn't make sense. Then I heard Alvin shout, no, loudly. Then a gun went off, twice, ever so loud, and Alvin screamed. Two men called Kay. I think that would sound very good in court.
Do you want to know how we knew Morton would be there?
Tell me.
Your bloke told us.
That's not true. I've already checked that out. WPC Page, an extremely reliable officer, swears that she never mentioned Morton's whereabouts, and neither did her colleague.
No, he never mentioned it. Look what he gave us.
For the benefit of the tape, Mr. Durant's solicitor has passed us a book of matches with the Camberton Hotel logo and address on it.
Look what's inside.
Annex room 6. Who wrote this?
Perhaps I could have that back. Think you'd better tell him all about it.
What would a tape on?
especially with the tape on.
No way I knew I dropped that book of matches there, sir.
I bet drop them you did.
Apparently, sir, yeah. Well, now I come to think of it, sir, I did lean over that snooker table. I must have fallen out of my top pocket then.
Why lean over the snooker table?
Well, Durant was playing snooker all the time we were talking to him, sir. I felt he wasn't paying proper attention. I leant over the table to remove the white ball. Seems a bit of a silly thing to have done now, sir.
Why write Morton's location on the book of matches in the first place?
For Polly, sir. When she was radioing Sergeant Cry, I thought she might want to relay it.
On the way back from your encounter with Morton, what made you suddenly go to see Janna and Durant?
Well, I seemed to be the only person who hadn't met these two Ks that everybody was talking about. And Sergeant Cry had recommended warning Morton off, so I thought it might be a good idea to warn the two Ks off as well. Also, I'd get to clock them.
Your actions short-circuited our entire operation.
Sorry, sir, but well, when Polly and I went to the snooker hall, we didn't know there was another operation. We thought you'd dropped it.
You didn't go there to provide an alternative solution?
Certainly not, sir. No way.
Although we all know Janna and Durant shot Morton, we might not be able to press ahead with it.
And why is that, sir?
Because your actions could be exposed. If proven intentional, you'd be personally implicated in a serious crime.
Sorry, sir.
So you should be. You'll be kissing your career goodbye.
Sir, everybody makes mistakes.
Yes, they do. But not such big ones. Bob, anything to add?
Yes, sir. In my opinion, sir, any officer who knowingly sets in motion a lawless chain of events, no matter how good his intentions, is no better than the criminals he's dealing with. Worse, in fact, because abusing the trust that's been placed in him.
Well, I can't stress how sorry I am.
I've only got one question to ask you, Eddie. Did you drop those matches in front of Janna and Durant deliberately?
No such. I swear.
In that case, sir, I think we have to accept PC Santini's word for it.
Thanks, Bob. Right, Eddie, we'll leave it like that for the moment. I might remind you that only the people in this room know about your carelessness in putting Polly at risk. I should keep it that way.
Thank you, sir. I hear what you're saying. Sir. Sarge.
Innocent till proved guilty. Hey, Bob.
That's what we live by, sir.
Hello, Sally. How you doing?
You turned on me, see, because of this. I would have grassed him up otherwise.
Yeah, you've done the right thing.
Carrie's waiting for you out front.
I'll take you through. This way.
Is that her statement?
Yep, the full works. Janna and Durant don't stand a chance.
What about Alvin Morton?
As soon as he can hobble, he'll be back in Longmarsh.
So everything we need to send the three of them down is in that statement?
With what we've got from Nadia Collins, the girls have stitched it all up.
Great. Can I have a look at it?
Yeah, of course you can, Sarge. Bang it back on my desk when you finish with it.
Yeah.
All in all, a good day's work.
Doesn't feel like it.
Eddie, you coming or what?
Sarge?
Yes, Eddie.
Just wanted to say thanks, you know, for backing me up in there.
No thanks required.
And give me the benefit of the doubt.
Eddie? You got away with it this time. But you ever step out of line like that again, and I can prove it. Make no mistake, I'll have you.
Sarge?
Sergeant Cryer, mending bridges.
Yeah, you could say that.